Hi everyone, welcome to Storytime with VIA. My name is Diana Collins and I'm the Member Program Coordinator at the station in the Membership Department. And I'm here tonight to read you a story, If You Give a Mouse a Cookie, by Laura Numeroff and illustrated by Felicia Bond. This is one of my all-time favorite books. Many of you may have read this book before, and I'm so excited to share it with you again tonight. Before we get started, I just want to thank all of our grant funders for so generously supplying the books to us at the station, and I hope that you enjoy the book. So If You Give a Mouse a Cookie, by Laura Numeroff and illustrated by Felicia Bond. If you give a mouse a cookie, you could see the mouse getting ready to leave his little treehouse. Here's the inside cover page. If you give a mouse a cookie, no, I had to have my cookies ready. Just the little boy getting ready to give the mouse the cookie. He's going to ask for a glass of milk. When you give him the milk, just gonna get my things ready for the mouse. He'll probably ask you for a straw. When he's finished, he'll ask for a napkin. Find the napkin. Then he'll want to look in a mirror and to make sure he doesn't have a milk mustache. When he looks into the mirror, he might notice that his hair needs a trim. So he'll probably ask for a pair of nail scissors. When he's finished giving himself a trim, he'll want a broom to sweep up. Gotta get the broom. He'll start sweeping and he might get carried away and sweep every room in the house. The mouse is getting a little carried away cleaning here. He may even end up washing the floors as well. When he's done, he'll probably want to take a nap. You'll have to fix up a little box for him with a blanket and a pillow. Got the pillow here. Getting the blanket. He'll crawl in, make himself comfortable, and fluff the pillow a few times. He'll probably ask you to read him a story. So you'll read to him from one of your books and he'll ask to see the pictures. When he looks at the pictures, he'll get so excited, he'll want to draw one of his own. He'll ask for paper and crayons. Gotta get our paper and crayons. He'll draw a picture. When the picture's finished, oh look, he drew a picture. He included his family here at the treehouse. When the picture's finished, he'll want to sign his name with a pen. Gotta get him a pen. Then he'll want to hang his picture on the refrigerator, which means he'll need scotch tape. Gotta go find the scotch tape. Got some scotch tape here. He'll hang up his drawing and stand back to look at it. Looking at the refrigerator will remind him that he's thirsty. After all that work, he's thirsty. He needs a drink. So, he'll ask for a glass of milk. Gotta get the milk. And chances are, if he asks for a glass of milk, he's going to want a cookie to go with it. The end. So the mouse wants another cookie. I hope you enjoyed If You Give a Mouse a Cookie. This is a circular tale. I'm sure you can figure out what that means. The whole story goes in a circle. And one of my favorite facts about this book, which is a bestseller, it was published in the 1980s, is that this author actually went to 9 different publishers before she was able to find someone to give her a chance and publish this book. So this book is now a series. You may have read the other ones. There's If You Give a Moose a Muffin, If You Take a Mouse to School. We all wish we had cleaning mice, that's right. So I hope you enjoyed If You Give a Mouse a Cookie. Now for parents or grandparents or siblings or aunts and uncles, VIA also has a book club, the VIA Page Turners. You're welcome to join our Facebook group and we're going to start reading JoJo Moyes, The Giver of Stars. So we hope you'll tune in for that. And every night here, visit us at this page at 7 o'clock for a story. We hope you enjoyed it and we wish you a very great night. Thank you.